following program shows the proceedings and hearings from courtrooms around the country. Not all outcomes are known or final. All parties are presumed innocent until proven guilty in a court of law. Due to the intensity of some of these scenes, viewer discretion is advised.
We're in Paris, Kentucky, where 30-year-old Bass Webb has been charged with two counts of attempted murder. This surveillance video, taken outside a Kentucky jail a week earlier, captured the moment when Webb, a former inmate there, who served 3 months on assault charges, accelerated his car and tried to run over two jail employees. One man was able to get out of the way, but one man was injured after Webb's vehicle pinned him against the wall. At his first court appearance before Judge Vanessa Dixon, Webb's bad behavior continued. Judge Dixon then informed Webb she's recusing herself from the trial because she knew the two jail employees he targeted with his vehicle.
There's no way I'm going to try this case or have any further proceedings, or I'll have to see you for one further set. Set for the hearing next week.
Watch again as Webb literally spit on the judge. But this incident is far from the last time Bass Webb will spit in the face of the law. While waiting to go to trial, he and four other inmates incited a riot inside the Fayette County Detention Center. After being shot with beanbag bullets and hit in the neck by a pepper ball, Webb whips a metal telephone box at a corrections officer.
If I were to launch this at someone 10 feet away, because this is capable of stopping that, does not mean that that is not readily capable of causing death or serious.
Webb was found guilty of third-degree assault and sentenced to 15 years in prison. And for his attempt to run over the two jail employees, he was later found guilty of two counts of attempted murder and got an additional 37 years. Bass Webb was facing a total of 52 years behind bars, but more disturbing accusations were on the way. While incarcerated, he was charged with the unsolved murder of an ex-girlfriend. Facing a possible death sentence if convicted at trial, Webb pled guilty to the murder and got an additional 50 years. Now, 5 years later, Bass Webb is back in court yet again after being charged with the murder of a different girlfriend nearly a decade earlier. The cold case came back to haunt him after a jailhouse tip led to the discovery of the woman's remains. This time, as he's let in, he reveals a new sinister look that shocks those in attendance. A closer look at Webb's recent head tattoos reveals a demented murder hit list. It reads, "Those that must die, all judges, all prosecutors, all cops, the media." Below that, three rats have been scratched out, and many more, plus an expletive on the other side. Gruesome details emerge about how Webb choked his then-girlfriend to death and buried her body in a shallow grave.
Mr. Webb, do you want to come forward?
When the judge asks Webb to come forward, he remains seated and smiles. Finally, after more than a week in the courtroom, the judge reads the jury's verdict.
You have found the defendant guilty of the offense of intentional murder.
Bass Webb is then sentenced to life in prison with the possibility of parole after 25 years.
A home should be a safe haven for all who dwell there, especially for children.
Next, we're in Jacksonville, Florida, for a hearing from the Court Cam Archives. A grandmother's on the stand, mourning the senseless loss of her young grandson.
I would never see him walk, play, smile, celebrate another birthday, Christmas, or realize his dreams.
Moments later, the courtroom erupts. That was the victim's family, and this was a fight that was a long time in the making. Nearly 5 years earlier, the defendants Andre Fisher and Derek Cummings were convicted of first-degree murder after killing a 5-year-old boy in his home during a drive-by shooting. Initially, both were sentenced to death, but the Florida Supreme Court later overturned it, ruling the killing was not premeditated, thus making it second-degree murder. With the death penalty now off the table, the men are back in court for resentencing.
Your Honor, I asked on behalf of my family, which has been altered for life, and the safety of our children and our neighborhoods, Please give the maximum sentence possible. Thank you.
With emotions already running high in the courtroom, the victim's grandmother then shows a photo of her grandson lying in an open casket. Off camera in the gallery, the sobering image is an unbearably painful reminder to the boy's family, especially his father.
See where they put him, what they did to him.
The distraught dad attempts to leap on top of the defendants. After the boy's father first attacks, watch as the other defendant jumps up and reacts, while more members of the victim's family pile on with fists flying. Someone even uses an umbrella. As one officer gets a defendant out of the courtroom, another stands guard on top of a table. Eventually, officers help the second defendant out of the courtroom and get everything back under control. The victim's father and two other family members are arrested and charged with contempt of court. As for Andre Fisher and Derek Cummings, they would later be resentenced to life in prison.